Welcome to another OxyCast webinar. In this webinar, we're going to discuss the ongoing challenges of mobile forensics. We'll cover three topics: remote wiping and the prevention of, selective extractions to ensure that you aren't grabbing the data that you shouldn't, and the third topic covers other data that exists due to a mobile device. Just in case you don't have the mobile device in your hand, the information may be accessible elsewhere.
Hello, everyone. Jordan Portfleet here with the Oxygen Forensic Training Team. In this video, I'm going to show you how to avoid remote wiping. Let's get started. When it comes to personal data, everybody wants to ensure that their personal information is protected. One way to ensure that your personal data is protected is by setting up a remote wipe. To set up a remote wipe on your Android device, now that we know that once the wipe command is requested, we cannot stop the command from being sent. So what do we do in that case? Some things we can do to stop the receipt of the wipe command is we can remove the SIM from the device. We can shut down our Wi-Fi network, or we can go to an area that we've never logged into Wi-Fi before. So this is important to keep in mind. Say you've used your neighbor's Wi-Fi or some Wi-Fi spots in your neighborhood. Make sure you get away from those areas and go to a place where there's absolutely no Wi-Fi available. Then you want to turn on your phone or log in. First thing you want to do once you log in is turn your phone on airplane mode. You're going to want to select settings. After settings, select security. Next, select device administration. Select device administrators and disable your Android device manager. This is going to help you stop the remote wipe command from being received. If you're fortunate enough to find your device before it has been wiped, what you can do is actually cancel your wipe. So the first thing you need to do is to find your iPhone on iCloud.com. You could select Click All Devices. If you can't see all your devices, click the name of the current device in the center of the toolbar to access the device list, and that's going to bring up your new device. Then from there, all you need to do is click Stop Erase Request, and then enter your Apple ID and password to stop the wipe from taking place. If none of the previous options are available, or if you have access to one, a Faraday bag is an excellent way to ensure that no signals are being transmitted back and forth to a selected device, whether it be your Android or iOS. A Faraday bag is a copper foil-powered enclosure that blocks all radio signals. It removes Bluetooth signals, RFID, GPS, and Wi-Fi exploits. Signals cannot penetrate its thick layers of intertwined copper mesh and plastic. And these are great because they're nice and discreet, and they can be as small as a wallet or a little purse. All you'd have to do as soon as you get your device, drop it right inside, ensure that it's closed up, and wait to open the Faraday bag and take your device out until you get to a Faraday cage. A Faraday cage is a device used by law enforcement, the military, and security organizations that does not allow any type of electric signal or wave to enter inside. So basically what you would want to do is take your iOS or Android device that's already inside of your Faraday bag and place both of them, the Faraday bag and the device, inside of the Faraday cage. Make sure the Faraday cage is secure, and then you can do whatever type of manipulation you need to do to your device, such as turning the device on to airplane mode or conducting an extraction from within inside the Faraday cage. The only reason you would need to do this is to make sure that it doesn't receive any type of signal that would allow a wipe to occur. They can come in many shapes and sizes. They can be as big as a locker, or they can be just a small little box that you have the option to conduct whatever type of examination you need in. To find out more about how to avoid a remote wipe, you can contact us at sales or training at oxygen-forensic.com.
Hey everyone, it's Ryan with your Oxygen Forensic Training Team, and let's talk about selective extractions. We have a couple different options to attempt to do a selective extraction. And it's important because depending on the scope, depending on the left and right limits of your investigation, And what data may be found on that particular device you're examining is going to determine whether or not using a selective extraction method is going to be useful. We have multiple ways to get into selective extractions, each depending on the type of operating system that you're looking to go after. For instance, let's take a look at our iOS agent. After we get connected to the device that we have, we get the option to select a full extraction or our selective extraction. Let's choose this option. In here, we see all of the applications that are available for selective extraction within this device. So if it's not available as an application on the device, it's not going to be shown here. So you get a front page view of what specifically you can select to go after at a device specific level. So if I only wanted to see Apple Messages, Apple Wallet, and Calendar, I simply select those things and I can start my extraction. This is what a selective extraction is going to look like, both for our iOS agent as well as using our Checkmate. Now let's take a look at our Android operating system. For Android, let's look at our Android agent. Select our device and our location where we want to store this data, and we'll conduct this extraction. After you get your device plugged in, the agent will install automatically, and then after granting some permissions, we can continue. From here, we get the options to extract all the data or to select data to be extracted. So this is going to be our selective extraction here using our Android agent. When I do so, I see this kind of familiar window. I get the option to specify which data I would like to extract from this device. Now, if there's a particular location you don't want to extract from this particular phone, you could unselect that here with these checkboxes. One, that can save time, and two, it may contain irrelevant data for you within this extraction. So once you've selected all the items that you'd like to extract, we click OK and we let Extractor run.
The last topic we're going to discuss is data that you can find elsewhere, data created potentially by someone's cell phone. So you're looking at the data, you're looking for the data off of a cell phone, but you don't have it in your hand. What do you do next? Well, as we know, that data does most likely not only live on that cell phone, but you have CDRs, which is the call detail record that you can get from your cell phone provider. You may have access to SD cards that may have been in previous phones or even that device. You may have access to that person's computer. You may have access to cloud credentials for that person. And if you have the scope to do so, you'll be able to grab data from cloud extractions. So if you're in their cloud accounts, then you're open to a whole new world known as backups. So you may have access to application backups like a WhatsApp or a Viber backup, or you may have a complete backup of the device itself. This could be an Android backup or an iPhone backup. Do you have access to the Apple account? Do you have access to their Google Drive? All of this can help you further your investigation without the cell phone in your hands. I'm going to show you a couple of data sets just like this. So I'm going to navigate to my case called Other Data. And the first thing I'm looking at is my cloud backup. Now, how did I get into this cloud backup? Let's say that I had the scope to gather data from this cloud account. Maybe it's an exigent circumstance. How did I get in here? Well, as you see down on the list a little bit is something called a desktop extraction. Let's say that I did have access to that person's computer. I run KeyScout, which is another tool that you get with Oxygen Forensics, on their machine. I triage it, but not only does it triage and capture RAM, it will also capture cloud credentials, tokens, and login credentials. So let's say that I did get a token and I accessed the Google account. That's how I did that. Desktop extraction. I gathered the data that I needed to access the account. So I'm in the cloud backup. And let's say that that same set of credentials, if that's what I collected from the desktop extraction, could also get me into the iPhone backup. So we're in the iCloud account now. So now I have a complete iPhone backup. Now, let's say this is an Android and I was in the Google account and I see that a WhatsApp backup is in here as well. So here we go. Let's pull that WhatsApp backup down. And if we have the correct information to decrypt it, we can now decrypt that backup. So here is an OCDR. That is a call detail record. I have processed the call detail record with the CDE. That's another tool you get with Oxygen Forensics, the call data expert. Processed it with that tool and I brought it over into Detective to be parsed, and we can see that we've got 24 items in our call data records. Now, this can be thrown onto Oxygen Forensic Maps, and you can follow the trail of the person according to the cell phone pings off of the towers. Also, a memory card file. This may or may not have been inserted into one of the mobile devices. We process that, we put it in our case. A drone, so let's say that a drone was located. This is going to have a lot of geodata in it. So let's navigate back to the home screen and I'll show you where these tools are. The cloud extractor, this is going to take you to all of the data living on other servers. Now again, you must have the scope to get into these. So let's just call this our other data. And now you have over 100 platforms that you can access if you have the credentials to do so. Here are all of your Google services. You can access WhatsApp backups, Viber backups, Line or Grindr backups. You can also access Apple services. If you have the credentials to get into the Apple account, you now have access to any of the iCloud backups. This could be the cell phone up to maybe an hour ago. Maybe that phone just auto-updated an hour ago. You don't even need the phone in your hands. Now you have the phone's data right here on your machine. The next tool is also located under Extract. This is Oxygen Forensic Key Scout. You can add this to removable media and run it on a machine at the location if you're performing a search warrant, or if someone is bringing their device into your office, you can run it on that live machine. You can also run this on a hard drive image. The next tool is under the tools section. Here we have our Oxygen Forensic Call Data Expert. This is where we're going to put our call detail records in, process it, and pull it over into Detective to compare it to the rest of our data in our other data case. Here's the mapping tool that you can place any of that data that you've collected from cloud accounts, CDR. Maybe you gathered some data, some EXIF off of images inside of an SD card. And maybe you have some data from that desktop extraction or that WhatsApp backup. We can place all of this on a map and each one will be its own individual layer. And then we can start to compare the data, follow the routes, and look at the common locations visited. Now, these are just a few tools that we have built into Detective. And once you own that license, you also own all of these tools. It is a all-in-one package deal for you. If you have any questions about the tool or you want to speak to someone in training, you can always email us, training@oxygen-forensic.com. Or if you're interested in purchasing a license, please contact us at sales@oxygen-forensic.com.